Yo, yo, I'm back on. Well, technical difficulties, shit happens. At least we got the whole music video in. Those guys, it's Tolo. Fucking love them. That place that they're at, High Grade Studios, fucking awesome. Thanks, guys. That place is, you've seen how beautiful that place is? It's old school. George Benson built it in the 70s. Shit's badass. Those lovely gentlemen let us borrow these mics and the soundboard and wires and all kind of cool shit. We got a video from them later in the show. Good old Poets of Power. I just want to say I love you guys. So, Mr. Zenderpants, what do you think we're doing over there? So, I guess we're going to show some pole dancing videos now, and the video by Cassie with some good old gas masks and chicks in bikinis and stuff. All right, check it out.
Perfect. We got the tape.
Just play that Cassie video like we were talking about. You can play that Cassie video, sir?
You may be experiencing a high volume of distortion and confusion. System stabilization sequence initiated. System purify is fully operational. Contamination detected.
Yeah.
Hey, I feel like I know a couple people in that video. I don't know. Maybe the sexy mom and dad with the kid, or maybe, I don't know. Maybe I don't know them. Maybe I know those people spinning fire on the beach and stuff. Who knows? But here we go. It's that time of the day. It's ladies' room, ladies' time. Come on in. Let me get rid of my favorite lady over here.
Hello, hello. It is Ladies Lounge. What do we want to talk about? Other than Fanny being late to literally everything, and she's not here right now. But other than that, she'll come.
She's Don't, late, but yeah. She always shows up.
She'll be here eventually.
Late, but beautiful. Ready for the potty. All right, Mother. Mother Amber.
Hello.
We have some questions to ask you about Mother's Day.
Uh-oh.
Being a mother during quarantine.
Ooh. Swallow.
So, what's the best thing about being a mother during this time?
Uh-oh.
Being a mother of a little toddler in the middle of quarantine, you're spending every single waking moment with your son. How does that make you feel?
It's actually really awesome. I know, I'm sure stay-at-home moms would are losing their shit because they already have to deal with this every day. But, I mean, I normally work 4 or 5 days a week, so it's amazing, especially, like, Mother's Day time. Like, I don't have to even think about requesting off work. I don't even have to think about going to work. I just know that I'm going to spend time with my kid. It's amazing. This is, like, a precious time because normally we're working and we get to spend all day with our kid. So it's awesome.
It's very true. I see this woman do amazing things. Her and baby daddy, I guess you could say Murph, they both make it work somehow. I don't know how they do it, but they both work full-time jobs. And they
No. Let's not get it twisted. We don't work full-time jobs. I work probably like 30, 32 hours a week. He works like 20 hours a week. So
check, yeah. Check.
I don't even know if he works 20 hours a week. Six, 12. He probably works 20 hours a week.
Still, though, balancing that, having a job and balancing being a parent must be a little bit difficult at times.
Yeah, it can be exhausting. I don't even know how people do it with more than one kid.
True.
That would be crazy.
Do you think that maybe this is your only one, your one and only, or do you think you could have another one?
Yes. Oh, we have another lady in the house.
Late to the
party. It's come on, Fanny. Woo!
Where's another microphone? Ladies and gents, it's Fanny Fong.
Do we have another microphone?
Here for the party.
So busy getting ready to go shopping tomorrow.
Woo! Ooh, yeah. Malls are supposed to open tomorrow.
Yep. Yeah, well, retail shops are opening
tomorrow. So all the shoppers are planning for what they're going to freaking buy.
What are y'all going to buy? It's shopping time.
We want to know. What are you guys
trying
to buy?
Spend that stimulus money, if you know what I'm saying. If you got it, I'm sorry if you didn't.
I think it's going to be a self-sustaining island here for a little while because we're going to be selling to locals, right?
I'm just excited about more food being open.
More food? Oh, I cannot wait
more
to-go
food, at least.
More restaurants opening up.
Movies? Are movies opening?
I don't believe so. Not
in have one on the west side anyways. We don't even have a movie theater on the west side of Maui, y'all. I don't know if y'all know.
Uh-uh. Can you believe
that? It was closed before.
It did close before, but I still get to bitch about it, okay? Okay, great. Andrew says he's going to bitch about it, too, because he used to go every single week.
What?
Oh!
Raver kid.
What's up with that guy's hair?
Let me see this.
Who is
Yo, looking for my rave, bae. Gucci, 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 Gucci. Gucci all day. Yo. Has anybody seen my rave, bae, around his Mother's Day? And I got a heart to give her. I love her. Yo. Hundo P. Yeah. If you open that up, it's full of ketamine. We're going to have fun tonight. Woo. I don't know. I just want to come say what's up to my girl. I love her. I know these other ladies in here, they're talking stuff, but none of that stuff is lit is the stuff I'm talking about.
Litty lit lit Gucci time.
Cracker. Woo!
In case y'all are wondering, a new Bass Nectar mixtape came out. That shit is flames. Lit, 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 lit.
Uh-oh.
All right, I got to go headbang in the other room. I got some rails to break. So I'll let you know, I love Amber Heiner.
Break those rails. Oh!
Woo! My rave, bae. She has turned. She has turned.
Beat it. I love you, but raver guy needs to go. Okay, so now what?
One guy's always got to crash the party for 2 seconds, but this is still Ladies Lounge, ladies and gentlemen. Hey. Still Ladies Lounge. What else are we talking about, Fanny?
Are we talking about mommy stuff or what?
Oh. Let's talk about mommy things.
Well, you and I don't have mommies anymore.
Not anymore.
So we have some memories.
Yes, if there's any women out there who do not have their mothers here with us anymore, we feel for you. We feel for you, girl.
So how long have both you ladies not have had a mommy anymore for?
Over 20 years.
Wow.
Almost 15 for me.
Oh, my God.
Yep. It's pretty crazy. Insane. It's kind of a hard holiday for some of us. Yeah. But, you know, we're still up here. We're talking about it. And that's the best thing that you can do. Talk with some friends.
Strong ladies.
Thank you. We appreciate that.
Yes.
Happy Mother's Day to everyone.
I do have a backup. My sister is pretty awesome. And so she was kind of like a second mommy to me, too. So happy Mother's Day, Mary.
All the sub mommies out there. Everyone's
I'll
got
be your
that.
Mommy.
Aw, she's my island mommy over here.
I have Fanny adopted mommies everywhere. You know what I mean? Like my friends' moms, yep. Like nice people like that have always like, you know.
That's why ladies got to stick together.
That's right.
We support each other through thick and thin, through bad times, good times. No matter what, we will be there for each other. So we got to get together, talk about things.
All about the wonderful women.
Yes, indeed.
How about you? What's did you talk to your mommy today?
I did talk to my mommy. I have a mother. I
she's awesome.
Would die if my mom died anytime soon. She's amazing. I can't even explain all the things that my mother's done that are great. I would talk for a million years. But she's a strong lady. Hopefully I take after her one day. You know, she's a little crazy, but aren't they all? You know, she's my mom that like sends me boxes every single holiday with like little cute things and stuff for my kid too. She's amazing. And of course I talked to her and made sure she was okay. It's like definitely hard living so far away when you miss your mommy.
But that's good. Yeah. I'm glad you said hi to your mom today.
Mm-hmm.
I always appreciate people who appreciate their parents.
Absolutely. Definitely call your mama. Unless yes. you like hate you your mom. Unless you have a shit mom and like you're like, fuck my mom for some reason. But still, try to just reconcile and think positively for things. Who's drunk? Not me. This is my first drink of the night. Thank
not
you.
Drunk
oh, okay.
Yet. We're getting there. I mean, oh, Andrew Stoffer says that his mom. It's called Susie Boozy on holidays like today because she likes to get down. And you know what? I appreciate you.
Ooh.
Mommy Stoffer. Oh, yeah. You get your
from.
Drink on.
That's where he gets it from. But I think he likes his liquid more clear. Vodka. Let's stop talking about boys.
Yeah, stop talking about
but,
the boys.
Happy Mother's Day, Boozy Susie.
Yes, happy Mother's Day to all the mothers out there.
Absolutely.
Alive and not, no matter how crazy that sounds. But,
yeah.
Anything else you'd like to talk about? The beauties of motherhood?
Did you get anything, any special treatment today for your Mother's Day?
Oh. I hope so. I certainly hope so.
You know, I got some special love today. I got some cute little gifty things, face masks and White Claws and my child
essentials.
Saying Happy Mother's Day like 10 times today. So that was really cute. Some like towels that are really cute, but aren't the right towels, you know.
It's okay. You know what? It's all about the effort.
It's trying. He's great. He treats me like a queen.
It's all about the effort.
Yeah, I was almost going to be really mad at him because, like, he took a nap, and I was like, this motherfucker, if I don't get a nap on Mother's Day and he does, I'm going to be real mad. But I got my little nap in, so we're good. Right. We're good.
He redeemed himself then, yeah?
He redeemed himself.
Good.
There's still the rest of the night to go. There might be more surprises.
It's true. Oh, so maybe true. He's got more plenty of surprises. I never know. Massages, I don't know.
You never know. Yep.
Well, I think, that's pretty much all I have to say. I mean, be grateful for your mommy.
Yes,
you're gonna
absolutely.
Miss her when she's gone.
Be grateful. Absolutely. Woo! Love your mommies. Tell them that they love you, that you mm-hmm. love them.
What are we on? Are we doing what? Ghostbusters.
Ghostbusters.
Ghostbusters. Who are you going to call?
Ghostbusters.
So basically we're done with the ladies' lounge. We're going to keep it sweet and simple. Talk about the mamas. We love the mamas. Whether you are a mom that has given birth, whether you did it naturally, you got the huge ass needle up your spine, whether you had to have a C-section, or whether you even adopted. That's amazing too, you know? Kids need adopted.
Oh, quick ladies' lounge survey. Were you all planned? Who was planned and who was an accident?
Oh, all of my siblings were accidents.
Accident.
But you know what? They loved us anyways.
Yeah, they do.
Accidents are okay. Not a lot of people really plan to have. Who's like, let's just have a kid right now? Maybe some people are really like that. And if you are, that's great. Good luck to you. I hope that you get pregnant. Keep on making love and making babies, or don't, whatever.
Or adopt.
Or adopt, exactly. If you're like
recycling,
I don't want to fuck up my body. It's just not really, not everyone gets a fucked up body afterwards. Take care of yourself. Use the cocoa butter Vaseline on your belly. Does wonders.
And Kegels are always a good exercise.
Even when you don't have a kid, just Kegels.
Yep, all the time. Okay. All the time.
Anyways, so now, you know, my son, he got his first job. He's now a Ghostbuster. Here's his first commercial. Check it out. Woo!
Ghostbusters.
Who are you going to call? Miles!
Oh, Miles.
Well, excuse me. Thank you. I love you, Mary Jane. But let's talk about some other stuff instead. So right now is a weird time, and there's like some stocks that are doing like and there's some stocks that are like woo right now, right? Not me, but I'm sure there's some assholes out there with extra cash that maybe wanna, you know, make extra cash from that shit. I don't know. But let's take a look at some of these notes. So, according to nerds on the internet, talking about nerd stuff, there's a couple of stocks that are doing really bad right now that are really known as good stocks. And you should probably buy them because they're going to go up even though they're bad right now, right? All right. So one of them, of course, Apple. Apple's down right now because everybody's thinking that the world is going to end and nobody's going to buy technology, yada, yada, yada. We all know that's a bunch of bullshit. the reason they're coming up is they got the new 5G phones, and basically every fucking thing coming out is about to be 5G. So buy yourself some Apple. Along that same fucking shit is advanced micro devices. These guys make the microchips and all the cloud storage and all that cool shit like that. Their stocks are down right now because whatever, people think technology is not going to work. That's dumb. We all know we're going to go back to fucking living robot life pretty soon here. So those guys, advanced micro devices, they do cloud stuff. They do fucking microchips. They're also a big investor in the 5G market, which, like it or not, it's coming. Conspiracy theory ass motherfuckers. We're doing 5G, like it or not.
Oh, speaking of 5G.
Hey. Woo! All right, so, and then Intel, of course. They got all the 5G. They got the AI, which we know that's going to take over our life pretty soon here. They could do a lot of, like, data sharing and all the self-driving vehicles, which is about to be a big deal, too. Fucking, I can't wait to get in that damn car with a plate of spaghetti and just ride. You know what I mean? Not have to worry about it. Damn, plate of spaghetti, bottle of wine, 6 hours later, half an ounce. Woo! I'm here at the festival. Thanks, car. No DUIs. Let me tell you what I think that they don't want AI to happen, right? One, lawyers make millions of dollars off of DUI cases, right? And so do the judges. And then if all these vehicles are up to code, they're not going to be able to pull you over for your safety. They're not going to be able to pull you over for your insurance because you don't got insurance. You're riding in the fucking AI car. So there's going to be like millions and millions of dollars lost in revenue for like the police and lawyers and judges and the mayor and all that bullshit. So they're going to make it look bad as possible for the whole fucking time. We all know that shit is about to be the shit. Some other shit that's doing bad. Fuck. Nike. People aren't going to the store to buy shit. So Nike stocks are down, and that's fucking stupid. Let's keep it real. When fucking everybody can go outside, everybody's about to be a fucking health nut, jogging ass, fucking going to Gold's Gym, working out too much ass motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? Getting your stupid ass. Maybe you should buy some stock in GNC because everybody's going to start buying that creatine and all that crap too.
He doesn't cuss this much in front of our kid. Don't worry.
It's the liquor. The liquor brings out the South Side. I'm sorry. Netflix right now is showing itself as the king of streaming devices. Everybody is buying more Netflix than any other accounts right now. Probably because it has the most content of movies and good shit like that, I guess. I like Netflix. I'm a Kodi user. I just steal everything off the internet. That's how I roll. So, some of the stocks that are crazy down, stuff you don't want to put your money into, crazy enough, makeup. Women can't go to the store to buy makeup right now. Two, they're not wearing makeup because they don't have to wear it to work, or they're not leaving the house. They're just hanging out. It says like 90% of women are makeup free right now. And 10% that are wearing makeup is because they have to go online or go to work for some dumb board meeting or something like that.
Show every Sunday.
Yeah, makeup on Sundays for the show. So yeah, women, you don't need makeup anyway. You're beautiful without it. Remember that, ladies. All right. The other shit is like office supplies and basically office space, big rooms for shit like that, because everybody's figuring out like, whoa, I can just set up the camera in my living room and a bunch of drunk assholes can talk for like 2.5 hours. It's fucking great, you know? Like office people can do that and strippers and whatever. Make your money. The other stuff, not to bring anybody down here who lives in Hawaii, but they call it the beach. It's the booking of stuff. It's the entertainment, the airlines, the cruises, and hotels. All of those are like doing the shittiest ever, shittier than anything. I don't think cruise ships are going to come back from this shit. It's going to take a long time before cruise ships come back. I don't know. I don't think people are going to want to be on a boat for 3 weeks with some random motherfuckers that they could probably die from getting a virus with. I don't know. That's me. Shit. So, I don't know. I guess we'll see what China does, and we should follow them a little bit because they've threw this shit already. So, something you should maybe think about putting your money into and not just buying it all the time is alcohol. Woo! Alcohol sales are through the roof right now. It's ridiculous. I know. I've been buying some alcohol. People in the house have been buying some alcohol. Corona sales, 281% past the projected quarterly sales. Good job. Oh! Whoever's calling me, quit calling me. I'm talking on the fucking microphone right now. Don't be a dumbass. So, alcohol. Woo! So, top 10 alcohols that are being purchased right now. Aristocrat Vodka, $6.99 a bottle. Fucking disgusting. If you guys at home are drinking Aristocrat Vodka, shame on you. Number two, Tito's. We all love Tito's. I don't even buy any other vodka anymore. It's just Tito's. It's the best for the money, I think. Tastes the best. And then Seagram's Extra Dry Gin. Fucking gross. That's all the old people at the retirement home or something. I don't know who's buying that shit. And Pinnacle. Smirnoff. Crown Royal. Fireball. Jack Daniels. Skull. Skull? You guys are drinking that? Parmesan Grande Amber. Woo! Okay. Good for you guys. Good for that. So, those are the top selling, right? But the top grossing, woo! Hennessy, number one grossing alcohol of the quarter. $6.8 million they made in this quarter, the beginning of the year. Woo! $6.8 million. Holy shit. Then next is Tito's. We all love that. Then Crown Royal, regular Crown that we all love. Then Jack Daniels. And then Crown Apple comes in his own category. That's crazy. They're making tons of money off Crown Royal, and then they're making tons of money off Crown Apple. Canadian whiskey, gross. But even grosser is Fireball. And that's next. Ugh, shit's gross, but they're making a lot of money. They're number six at top grossing in alcohols in America right now. Good job. Smirnoff is next. Jim Beam. Then the Aristocrat, because they got to sell like fucking five bottles to equal out the other bottle. And then the Seagram's Extra Dry Gin. That's pretty much the worst thing I could think of drinking, honestly. I mean, Zen, what would you rather drink than Seagram's Extra Dry Gin? Yeah, and yeah, vodka. Well, obviously vodka. Vodka is, they've got one, two, three, four, five of the top selling alcohols in America is vodka. Yeah. Fucking vodka. Woo! Let's hear it for vodka. Woo! You can't, you know, you can't smell it as much on your breath as whiskey. Vodka. You know, it mixes great with lemonade and Sprite and all that shit. So, I was looking up some whiskey shit because I'm a big fan of whiskey, as we could tell. Maybe we should pour another shot around here. But, so, we all know popular whiskey, Louis XIII, right? Yeah, it's good stuff, I heard. So, that's $3,500 a bottle. That's $3,500 a bottle, right? 25 shots in a bottle of whiskey, that's $140 a shot at cost. That's crazy. That's, what does that cost at the bar? Fuck, I don't know, $400? Stupid. And then there's the Louis XIII rare cask. Guess how much that bad boy goes for? $41,000 a bottle. $41,000 a bottle. 25 shots. That's $1,640 a shot. At cost. For you. What would that be at the bar? $5,000 shot? $3,000 shot? I don't even fucking know. It's ridiculous. If you know, Let me know. Shit. That'd be awesome. So that's enough of that crap. You know, we got like some more videos coming up. What we really need is you guys to send some videos in. I know you guys are creative. I know you can make up some fake commercials or play your guitar in your room or at the beach or get a hippie drum circle going with your friends or spin some fire or spin some poi or butt chug a beer. I don't know. Like, let's get creative here. Let's have fun. I got some music videos coming up here. I got Fanny Talks with her friends. We got Andrew coming in with Did You Know? Got my friend Mermadia. She's going to come in and talk about some fun stuff. I think my buddy Arnold's going to call Sam Jackson this time. I think they're going to have a good talk.
I got to save
them
my phone.
So, I don't know. We want to get Corona Clown in here for a second?
Corona Clown?
You want to roll some of those videos? We'll do with let's do some Poets of Power. These guys, High Grade Studios. Thank you, bro. You know I love you. You're awesome. Looking out for the community. Giving back. Putting the local scene out there, giving people a place to play and shows. Woo! Taking a shot.
All hands up to the ceiling. When sounds vibrate the building, let's hold on to this feeling. We do this for the thrills. When all hands up to the ceiling. When sounds vibrate the building, let's hold on to this feeling.
Launch back, front to back, yeah. People fighting for drinks. Here we go, another show, we know what's getting in. We never reach capacity, the sound is sweet and so is the crown. I raise my glass to high grade before I swallow it down. I could spend my whole life reliving nights like these. In 20 minutes we'll be putting on a show like Grease. It's an anomaly and all I see is ass for weeks. It's like a colony around the bar of dancing freaks. I got the Holy Trinity and it's about to be on. Put the script and ordered up a couple shots of Patron. I'm being thrown around the room in harmony from exchanges by those who love the show and the way High Grade arranged it. My heartbeat's pounding and everything's gravy. The dance floor's crowded and everyone's crazy. The cash box stuffed while I step to the stage and now I feel yelling on the mic, yelling out High Grade.
We do this for the thrills when all hands up to the ceiling. When sounds vibrate the building, let's hold on to this feeling. We do this for the thrills when all hands up to the ceiling.
Hey guys, I hope you're enjoying the weather.
On the stage, hey, feeling hey, the vibe. crowds alive, smoking cigs right outside. Oblivious to the ridiculous, ambiguous, not simpleton is me who put myself in this position. From written is bitten, practicing vision and wisdom, the passion risen in minute, the mic I'm gripping, constricting. This is the life that I'm living, the gift that I'm giving. Every day I'm eating it, yo, be noble, here to win it.
Yeah, this is the mission, just a little bit different. Delivering the shit that you motherfuckers wish you would spit. This ain't no silly poe pimping, bitch, I'm with my comrades. Blazing up the stage, get you high in contact. Now when the brawl's there with a sticky cross set, pinkies in the sky, we'll be sipping cognac. Yeah. You got the feeling,
that's right,
I know you mean it. You know you fucking with your boys, T-Penis.
Let's get it on.
The
glamour, we come to share our swagger. We've opened in the club, we bring the people here together. Kick back on wine, wear the 9 to 5, no matter. Let the music ease your pain, sipping through, exchanging chatter, shifting energy for the better. We all in this together, so throw your hands up, strut your booty, let your trunk, get out your head, get in the funk. Let go, live up the life you want. Shit is real, this ain't no front. Be a player, not a punk, yo.
We do this for the thrills, when our hands up to the ceiling, when sounds vibrate the building, let's hold on to this feeling. We do this for the thrills, when our hands up to the ceiling, when sounds vibrate the building, let's hold on to this feeling.
We gotta do this, but with some constant twist and transform the naked into the way an optimist would. Chopping beats the lumberjack, I'm chopping this wood. Name another crew, on now we dropping this good.
Oh, baby, rocking this. Oh, what a positive look. And if you didn't know, then you probably should. Who's the poet with the power to bind rhyme to word? The time that you heard make hearts find the curve.
Bring it real for sure, rhymes thick and pure, cause we all need some relief from this
heavy ass world.
Where nothing is for sure and everything's always changing, making way for high terrain with a steady ass aiming.
Way off the mainland, on the stage the place jammed. This is food for thought and we're the placemat. Out of the back end, out of closed caption. This is how it happens, this is high grade.
This is game expansion.
Do this for the thrills, when our hands are to the ceiling, when sounds vibrate the building, let's hold on to this feeling.
Yeah.
Oh, hey, we need a light check. Hey, guys. I hope you're
enjoying. Hi, everybody. Welcome back to the show. I'd say we're getting a little bit better every week, learning, but we're still not perfect. So
messing up sometimes.
Yeah, yeah. But wanted to include in this week's episode two episodes that I shot in the previous weeks, but we didn't get to include them in the show. We wanted to be sure to include them because these guys are awesome for giving us their time and trying to be a part of this. I have two episodes. The first one we kind of lose visual on, but it's still going. You'll still hear the audio for the Nick Hoff one. And then the Cindy one should be fine. And we might be changing things up next week. And I'm developing a game show. So next week we might have something new from
Foul
Words with Fanny Fong.
Oh, man, I'm really good at that.
But for now, this week, enjoy these episodes. First up is Nick Hoff and Cindy. And then the next one is Cindy and Zach.
Woo! Love you guys.
Enjoy.
Hey, guys. I hope you're enjoying the webisode. We have a lot of kinks, technical difficulties. It's funny how things go great the night before when we're doing QA check, and then the day of it gets all crazy. Might have to do the fact that I think everybody in the world might be hungover today. Practically every person I talked to today is a little hungover because they decided to tie one on Saturday night. Anyways, bear with us. Hopefully we'll get better and eventually have an episode where we don't have any problems. And due to that hangover reason, excuse me, I have a very short segment today. People dropped out because of this or that, but we do have Nicholas Hoff from Napili today, and my friend Cindy from who's in Makuau. This whole segment is just trying to find out what other people are doing during this time, because we got nothing but time. Anyways, hopefully we'll have a fuller segment next week, but so stay tuned for that. But today, let's go meet Nick and Cindy. Enjoy. We are calling Nicholas Hoff. He's a pro at quarantining because he has been staying home for a few weeks before we even started. And look at him! What a pro! He's having so much fun. What's going on, Nicholas?
I just came here with my mystery visit, Misery here at COVID-19.
Oh, hi, Henry.
He's chilling. We chilling.
Nice. You guys got matching hats?
Hey, you got to talk to somebody when you're at home alone. He's the best roommate.
Wow. He's got really pretty eyes.
Boogers.
What's that? You got another friend hanging out with you on the counter there?
Yeah, I got
Mr. Jack and Bernito. Oh, that's a deadly combination.
Hey, you gotta have friends in times like these.
Absolutely. So, how's life been up in the Philly?
Everything's good. You know, we still go to the beach, we still surf, we still do our thing.
Nice.
The only thing is, we just have a day off, and we have a beach to ourselves now.
Absolutely. You have been sending out a lot of funny things lately. What's the best one for today?
You know, I'm going to have to get back to you on that one because I just woke up. I'm hungover from yesterday.
You know what? This seems to be a trend because every single person I've talked to has said the same thing. Good game, Tequila. Good game.
That's it.
All right. Well, have you gone fishing or anything lately?
No, I haven't done no fishing. I've just been swimming for exercise, that's all.
All right. Are you planning any trips soon, solo? We can still fish, right? Yeah.
We can still fish. I still got a broken hip. I can't walk on the sand that much.
Limited. All right. Well, then you finish healing, and maybe we'll check back in with you next week.
Over and out.
Oh, you froze it. Bye. So we're giving Cindy a call. She is going to...
Hi.
She's one of my funnest friends. And so since we've been in quarantine, we are just finding out what fun stuff they've been up to keep themselves entertained. This is Cindy.
Hi.
Oh, you look much better in this. The quality is much better in this video from yesterday's trip. I like it. Yeah. So Zach is very hungover today because
too much tequila
got him, and everybody I spoke to today has been hungover. So I think everybody is trying to pretend. Woo!
A tequila.
That's a big bottle, Mama.
Yeah, that's what we drink.
Ay, ay, ay. Ay, ay, ay. I know. And,
this is my style.
Yes. See, that's where you guys went wrong. You veered off the track. Although, I do like a nice tequila sometimes.
That's why I'm not very deep.
Huh? I like it. I actually had some during quarantine as well.
What, Jameson or tequila?
Tequila. Yeah.
Actually, it's not bad for being cheap.
Uh-huh.
It's actually really good.
Okay.
Yeah.
I think I've actually, well, I don't know if I've tried that one yet, but.
Yeah, it's a silver, it's a good thing, tequila.
Mm-hmm.
My tequila shooting days are over.
Ah.
It's no Cuervo for sure.
I'm a little sipper of all kinds.
Yeah,
yeah,
for sure.
Yeah. So. Next week, we'll have the whole dynamic duo, and they're going to show us some fun stuff. There might be games.
Yeah.
There might be other characters. They might look like Cindy and Zach, but they might not be Cindy
and Zach. Never know who's going to show up.
There could be yummy things involved. There could be fun games or who knows what.
New sexual positions.
Yeah.
No, I'm just kidding.
Yeah, with demos. Live demo. I mean, we've already seen most of them, if not all of them.
Most of them.
Yes. So,
I have to share with you, Jamie.
Yes.
I just got this in the mail.
What?
It's pretty cool.
I love it.
Rick and Morty tribute to the
Tiger.
Lion King. The Tiger King.
I love it.
This t-shirt will forever be remembered as the quarantine t-shirt. The quarantine show of the year.
It's awesome. Oh my god. So, have you guys been eating in mostly or cooking at home or going out once in a while?
Lots of cooking, lots of dishes,
lots of cooking and dishes and cooking and dishes. Yes.
Where's my place to get out? Already.
We had some Thai food from. We live on in my Wailuku, so we went to Mai Thai Maui.
Nice. I keep
forgetting. It was really, really good.
I keep forgetting that there's some places open, and I think I'm almost due to have something outside in the house. I've been eating a lot at home too, and
it's good. Sometimes you need a break.
Absolutely.
Cool. Even after you spend $400
to possibly still be right. Right. Hey, we finally scored some toilet paper this week at Costco, so that was a good thing. So we're looking forward to seeing you both next week.
Thank you.
Stay tuned for more fun with Cindy and Dad.
Bye, everyone. See you next week.
Bye.
Are you looking for some more pizzazz in your backyard? Quarantine got you bored? Are your kids driving you bonkers? You tired of watching Tiger King?
No, Daddy!
I got the solution. It's Intex Floaty Oasis. Ideal for relaxation. And play.
Bye again. Yay. That was Cindy and Nick. Thank you guys for being on the show. That
also
was the week that everybody was hungover.
Shade
and this next episode, people weren't quite as hungover, and they were actually able to get ready for the show. So
Thank
for this
biscuits.
Next one, Zach and Cindy are showing us
Thank
some fun
them
stuff. One of my favorite games that I love to play with them, Saber Beats, is a virtual game
on Amazon
with two
or our website,
lightsabers and a bunch of electronic music. It's super fun.
On the interweb.
But check it out.
Calling Zach and Cindy. Today they're going to show us my favorite game, Beat Saber. I love it so much. I always make them play when I see them at their house.
Hi, Cindy.
Hi. How are you?
What's going on?
Nothing. Hi. I wish I was with you guys right now and dressed up in my fun outfit.
Fun outfit? What? We're just like trying to get ready to go to sleep.
I know. That's fun sleepwear.
This is how we go to sleep.
I know.
It's just like we're trying to switch it up a little bit, you know? Like, it's getting boring around here.
Are those, what are those little, they're little Martian mini dudes. Triple X.
Remember? Toys and there's more.
Yes, they're so cute.
Cindy's playing some Beat Saber.
Yes, I was telling them. This is my favorite game.
I'll give you a little lowdown.
Okay.
Let me flip this screen around. She's looks pretty cool.
Tell us about the game and how you play.
I will.
Tell them how you
play. So, it's virtual reality.
Yes.
And she's in there with two lightsabers. And as the blocks come down the channel,
check.
You have to swipe them in the proper direction. To the beat of the music as well, so it's super fun.
So for you guys, I'm actually going to try to play a hard level first time of the song.
This is hardcore. I mean, this stuff comes so fast.
You guys ready?
Ready!
It's a workout. Here she goes.
I get super sweaty when I play. Can we show the screen too? She's pretty fun.
She does. Oh, yeah, it comes down the channel.
I grab another one. Yes, Cindy! You can actually... Oh,
but... Dude, we just started getting good enough to do the hard levels.
Oh, man, you guys are going to kick my butt next
and
time.
We impressed ourselves. I mean, I had no idea I had reflexes like that.
Killing it, Cindy! Yeah, this also has a bunch of different songs that you can choose. And so,
we got Green Day, all sorts of different artists that are.
So, can you load new songs onto this, or are you limited to what they have?
Every once in a while, they come out with new packages with different songs, mostly like, you know, techno or type of. It's funny, we were.
I want
to
play with you guys right now.
The other day, and and it was at like the gym or something, and they came on, and it was one of the Beat Saber songs. It was hilarious.
Oh my God.
We were like, oh yeah.
That's awesome. So that wall that comes towards her, like she has to also like move over to make sure it doesn't crash into her, because if it does, Deadsville.
Right. She's got to duck or go.
Hello. Welcome to Did You Know Nerd Version. Actually, it's always nerdish, but get in here, Murph. Yeah, shit, we gotta do shot.
Shot time. Nerd shot.
Zen, I hate you. God damn it.
Nerd shot time.
A lot of crazy things happened today. There's lots to talk about. Lots to talk about in the nerd session. I mean, you guys can also call in, too. If you guys have my phone number, you can yell at us.
Thank you.
You can yell at us on the phone. You can yell at us on Facebook, and hopefully we see it on Facebook. But if you really want a question asked, like, or answered, you need to, like, call me.
Go ahead. Call now, Kirk. I can answer the phone. I have it now. Call. You can talk to Andrew.
Kirk, go to bed. Eat some raviolis from Chef Boyardee and go to bed.
And drink some White Claws.
Vienna sausages, baby.
I like Vienna sausages. Yeah.
So what's going on in the world of nerds today, Andrew?
Oh, wait.
It's shot time. Wait, hold on. Don't let this guy start talking. He'll never gonna shut up. Let's take a shot. Let's take a shot.
Oh.
You. Gay.
You. Dick. What a dick.
We got more people. Actually, go ahead. Start.
Corona Clown is on the way.
Well, God, I'm trying to, like, start some. Hey, Chris, talk.
Go ahead, Chris. Let's hear what's new in your nerd world.
What's new? I was
he doesn't know. He was hoping to talk about what I talk about. I got so much fucking shit to tell everybody.
Hey, we're talking question.
I ended up talking about Skyrim last week with Andrew.
And yes. What'd you do today, Chris?
I got to level 30 in about 3 days. Averaging about 12 hours a day. I actually had to work, so I had something in the way.
Oh, you are going to hell for sure.
Yeah. It's shot time.
Get your shot glasses. Let's go.
I also played a little bit of Assassin's Creed Odyssey. Got in there.
Did you hear about that new Assassin's Creed game?
Yeah, I know. They just dropped the trailer. Woo!
Stoked. Fucking looks
Valhalla, right?
Thievery.
Yep, Valhalla.
Yep.
Dude, Viking Assassin's Creed. You think he's dead in that trailer, and then he fucking... Weak with the freaking assassin's blade,
yeah,
right?
No, my favorite's Ezio, though. I love Ezio.
Oh yeah, dude. Yeah, I cried during all like two and a half of those games, because the third game's kind of not him, but you know what I mean. The Brotherhood is the end. But then did you watch the video?
No, I did not.
The movie.
Yeah.
It's his end. That's how he dies. But it's nice.
Yeah, no, the movie was pretty.
It's good. He's all gray hair. He had a wife and a kid and stuff, and he killed a whole bunch of bad people, and then he finally perished. He was probably like, 65 back then. That's pretty impressive.
What, shot? Yeah.
All right, here we go.
We got the proper here. We got the JMO over here. Wait, hold on. Corona Clown needs one. He still needs one. Hey, you ladies taking a shot, or are you just laughing?
Oh, this is going to fucking
hurt.
Let's
go. Let's go. We're taking it without you. I know. I only yelled shot like 2 minutes ago. Come on. Everybody at home, get your shots ready.
Cheers.
Eye contact.
Ah, I looked at all your eyes. You just didn't see it because I'm creepy.
Nectar of the gods. Hot in here with all that whiskey. Woo.
Oh.
So back to So Skyrim. Skyrim's a new jam for you right now.
No, that's the old jam.
It's the old jam, but it's the new jam again.
It's the new old jam.
So we're looking forward to Skyrim.
The quarantine jam.
Elder Scrolls 6 is what we're looking forward to, but Bethesda's smart and they said they're going to wait for the next generation of consoles.
Which should be dropping in November?
Well, for PS5, Xbox got announced yesterday as far as specs, and it crushed PS5 specs, and I really am pissed about that. But I'm still going to buy both.
We all know Xbox ain't shit.
Oh, Xbox number one.
PS5, we all know it's going to be way better, yo. I don't care what y'all say.
People are going to buy it, that's why.
Xbox is for fucking...
Nah, the specs on the new Xbox PS5, are
we all
insane.
Know. Real motherfuckers know.
Where did all my shit go?
Y'all didn't play Tony Hawk on that fucking Xbox, did you?
No.
No, you played Tony Hawk.
Yay, some spades! Yay, some spades!
You played Tony Hawk on the 64 back in the day.
That I'm sorry for you.
Yeah, N64.
Doesn't matter. It was better on PS. Dude, Nintendo got crushed by PlayStation for straight, like, 7 years.
I know. They discontinued the Switch last year.
And then what? Fucking Xbox tried being PlayStation.
Hold on. I'm getting through my...
No, PlayStation.
Y'all know that PlayStation controller is better. No, PlayStation was out before that whole...
Yeah, but then they started charging. Well, they had free gameplay online, and then they started charging it because Xbox was charging.
Get them.
They had to keep up, you know?
Get them.
What a bunch
Xbox
of assholes.
Was way better.
Hey, thanks for charging fucking Xbox when PlayStation was giving it for free. Remember they had their free arcade you could go to and play all that free shit and like with your sim and talk to people and be like virtual and all that stuff? Yeah, I think PlayStation did that shit a long time ago.
Dude, PlayStation went nuts earlier. Like back in the day, it's like Final Fantasy VII came out exclusive on PlayStation 1 in 1998, and it sold more copies per capita versus what year it is, you know what I mean? Whatever the fuck you guys, you nerds, yep. Like you actual like financial nerds, where the hell I want to call it, per capita, I'll call it. Dude, that game sold so much fucking shit. Like, how many copies did Final Fantasy VII sell? They were out of it. More so than the PS2 itself when it came out.
Oh, shit.
Yeah. Any guys played Final Fantasy VII Remake? No?
No, I have Xbox.
plays at this guy's points. Fuck Xbox.
Yeah, fuck Xbox.
I'm still going to buy both, but, you know, that's because I'm a super nerd.
Candy Mountain, Charlie. Going to Candy Mountain.
All right. So we're going to talk about Last of Us 2. Just got all the shit. They say everybody spoiled the entire plot. Like Naughty Dog literally like gave up on life because somebody like leaked the plot from their studio. I haven't read it yet because I don't give a fuck. What are you doing over there? You just humping Michael Jordan?
Oh, no,
Jordan,
Michael getting in the front.
He's ready to go.
I don't know, already. Michael Jordan, would you? Yeah, well, come on. Why not?
What? No.
What? Yeah, I probably wouldn't
I'll
either.
Steal shit from his crib or whatever.
I couldn't go through with it.
That shit.
What was I talking about?
I don't know.
Damn it. You don't remember shit. Either? Which one?
Some nerd shit.
Nerd shit.
Yeah, you're talking about nerd shit.
No, Last
Diablo
of Us.
Diablo 4.
Diablo 4. Once Thanks, you beat Alba. That game once, you're over it. Get over here. Get out of here. Get out of here.
Hey, we got a guest.
Oh, yeah. You want to come up for the nerd talk?
Come on.
Nerd talk.
Hey, you can take my spot.
She's prettier than all of us.
It's getting a little nerdier in here. Oh. Shenanigans.
Sorry, but I drank some whiskey and some vodka before this, and thanks to this guy's blunts, I'm definitely fucked up.
I think you're a little...
Hope, what do you want to talk about?
You a little tall over there still?
I was asking about the Diablo 4 trailer, because I recently saw it. I was one of the last people...
I was very disimpressed by it. It looks like... Oh, okay. No. Say what you said again. The Diablo 4.
Yeah, so I recently saw the trailer, because I'm like the last person on Earth to see it, and... Yeah, I thought it was kind of kick-ass. Like, I'm guessing the new plot's going to involve Lilith, which is going to be kind of neat. But what are your feelings on, I guess, the Diablo 4 or Diablo franchise in general?
Well, I'm one of those old men that went through Diablo 2, and I still believe that is the best of the Diablos. Okay. The loot system's way cooler. Oh, someone's calling me.
Oh,
it's Fanny. All right, hold on. Put you on speaker.
Do you want me to ask you a question about sports or superheroes?
What's that again?
Do you want me to ask you about sports or superheroes or anything?
You can ask me about anything you want.
What is that white stuff that they throw before a sumo wrestling match, and why?
What's the white stuff? What? Hold on. The white stuff for what?
The white stuff.
That's actually really okay. So she asked me. All right, Finn, I got you. I'm gonna answer right now. So she asked what the white stuff is they throw before a sumo wrestling match. So my answer to that is any awesome kung fu movie you ever see is that's just powder to make shit look cooler. But for them, it's for their chafing. Lots of chafing because they're fat and they know how to fight. That's what it is.
So it's basically baby powder.
Well, they throw it just to, I don't know, maybe make it. I mean, if they leak some powder and they do that at the beginning of the match, it's like that helps.
I don't know. I don't
make
like
them
chafing.
Not look like idiots.
I don't like chafing at all. So.
Oh, I got skinny and then I stopped worrying about chafing. Where'd Murph go? All right.
He got a phone call.
So back to Diablo. I wasn't impressed with the trailer. It looked more. It looked just like Diablo 3, to be honest.
Okay, but like, so I feel like the trailers are always like really interesting, like cinematically. But it kind of gives you like hints and ideas about what we're gonna be seeing in the actual game. And I, for one, am excited about Lilith. I think that's a really cool concept. So
if that's a whole deal, then I'm down with it. But honestly, like Blizzard has kind of fucked themselves away as far as supporting Diablo 3.
Yeah, as far as the company goes, I mean they've done some pretty shady things.
They've had to sell out.
Not the best game ever.
They've had to sell out like three different times to get more investors and stuff. So I'm like, yeah, okay. Sorry, Blizzard. You guys had the fucking franchise of StarCraft and Diablo, and you pooped it away. Sorry. You know what I mean? I feel bad for them. But if Diablo 4 launches and it's fucking amazing, they should just make a Diablo that's like third person over the shoulder. Like Resident Evil 4. Like, you know what I mean? What do you think, Chris? Like,
you know, like, you know.
Or like God of War 4, or like the new God of War, I mean.
Never played God of War.
God, because you're an Xbox bitch. Oh, look at this cutie.
Hey.
Hey, my mom is up next. You
don't
know what I'm coming on. I just don't
want to
miss it.
Hey. Zen, how much time we got left? A little bit. Okay. Murph, you're back. Hope, do you have any more things to talk about? I think we went a little bit too deep about Diablo 4.
Oh, man, nobody cares about Diablo 4, right?
Oh, let's talk about Last of Us. Let's talk about Last of Us 2 a little bit. I was talking about Last of Us 2. That's going to be amazing. Anybody that played the original game, wow. Obviously, Chris, he's an Xbox fag, so he can't play that stuff because it's PS only. But they say they leaked it like, you know, they leaked the plot. Everybody's mad about it. I watched the trailer. It looks amazing. I can't wait to play it. Literally can't wait to play it. I know anybody that's watching that has played Last of Us 1, the remastered version on PS4, either what, doesn't matter, is literally licking their chops right now to play it. And, you know, also, I know I don't have a lot of time left. You guys can do what you want with the Last of Us 2 stuff and look it up for yourselves. It's easy to find on Google. The next gen consoles, it's sad how much more powerful than the Xbox, that the PS5 is than the Xbox. It sucks, or the Switch, that, sorry. But, like Murph said, yeah, I'm wasted, sorry. I said that earlier.
I know, I just used a green one. I said earlier.
Anyway, I was green. Okay, so yeah, basically, yeah, I'm sad that the PS5 didn't really fucking pull the stops, but guess what? When do you think Xbox is going to come out? A year after the PS5. Suck it. The next gen will be the definitive with Sony. I
have a feeling that the PS5 is going to do like a really good VR component, right? I feel like it's going to be...
We're old. We don't care about VR.
The note, I do. Shit, I can't wait to get in there, play some lightsaber VR, fucking whoop everybody's ass in some VR bowling and shit. I can't wait.
I wait for my neighbors to buy that shit.
I'm
going to
get a fake
there.
Shake and a fake motherfucking cheeseburger somewhere in the VR world just to do it.
I'm sorry, man.
For real,
I like my video game chair. I like my video game chair. I'm gonna sit back and use my controller and look at an actual badass TV. I'll do VR when I'm drunk and eating pizza or something. It skips. That's pretty much the thing.
Right. I'm talking about.
But you can love it. You can love it.
Future.
You can love it.
PS5 is gonna be out for like 7 years before they put out another one. So
I'm saying Xbox will be way behind that as far as it'll be like a year. But I bet before it comes out.
And then you buy it and then you just throw it in the garbage when you're done.
You buy it, you plug it in, you say, yeah, this is trash, and then you just put
it's
it
like
in the garbage.
It's like vegan bacon. Yes, I'll have another.
Just turn it into
throw in the garbage. The yes, I'll have another.
Local shelter in the by the house. And they
Parks,
play and, the Xbox
Parks and Recreation
at the
right there.
Faking?
I was going to talk about Batman and all sorts of stuff. But
let's hear about your new Batman news. Well, let's hear your Batman news, and then we'll close it out.
No, I was going to say, did you know that Kevin Conroy did so many voiceovers for Batman? Oop. Oh, sorry.
I thought you were giving me a voiceovers about. For Batman.
So he did the entire Batman, the animated series. He's done, I think it was, 12 movies, animated movies for the voice of Batman. And he did other voices like Penguin and shit during it. What a badass. I mean, who doesn't love the Batman animated series? That's my childhood. I mean,
big square chin ass Batman.
Anybody watch that movie, The Mask of the Phantasm? It was in theaters, actually. Same art, same same voice actors. It's a really, really depressing movie.
So
but Batman's kind of depressing.
We got
Well, you know.
I've been trying to play this video for a couple weeks now, but I haven't got to play it.
Love you guys.
Let's go to Murphy's video of the week. We're going to play this one for Andrew because I figure he's into this stuff. And then I got Mermedia coming up next, y'all. Let's hear it for Nerd Talk, y'all. Nerded it out. If you guys got any nerd questions for next week, send them in, and we can ask these guys what the real deal is, you know what I mean? Like, yeah. Andrew wants you to put it straight in the group.
It's time for a pig to get the
cups. Ask
them
questions wherever you want.
It's been 4 hours. He's got things to do today, so he can't sit around all day sitting in his tit cups. So here we go. There's one tit cup off. Oh, this one's a tight one. And there's the other one. Oh, look at these titties, eh? Look at these titties. Jiggling titties, eh?
You mean esports?
Yes, eh? I love my titties. Yes, I do. Ah, oh, baby, baby, baby. What a pig Norm Summerton is. I am a pig. Wee, wee, wee. Wee, wee, wee. A pig with tits.
So, there you go. Thank you, sir. Like I was saying, how about that video? Yeah. Sexy, man. He's fucking got a pig on his head. He's property of somebody's cuckold suction cup titties. That one's kind of for you, Beth. That's the saggiest titties I think I could show on here without being kicked off for saggy titty videos. I want to let you guys know that, you know, there's a good friend of ours named Beth. She sent in a great video of saggy titties, some very saggy balls, and some fun stuff like that. But pretty sure the song is a copyright song, and we couldn't play it because we don't want it to get pulled, you know? It's John Mayer, Gravity. It's genius. Fucking genius. Cheers to you, Beth. Ow! So, it's that time of day where we're going to go deep in the water here. We're going to go deep in the ocean. Get some ocean facts. I'm going to bring in the sexy Mermaidia. Come on in. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, Mermaidia. There you go. Here you go. Here you go. All right. All right. So.
Hello. How are we doing?
She's here to help me out, talk about some ocean facts and other great nautical things that maybe you didn't know. So what do you want to start out with this week there, Mermaidia?
So, you know, I'm thinking of just doing a different type of creature that lives in the sea and talk about them a little bit because I've been down there for a while. Mermaids, I don't know if you know, mermaids live a really long time. I don't really like to talk about my age, but I will, just for the knowledge. 138.
Woo!
Thank you.
It's older than you.
It's older than you.
Not older than Solo, yeah. though.
Solo.
Solo is like 159 years old.
He says. He could be older. Who knows?
He could be older. Old guys lie about
the
their age.
Entire life. Anyways, you know, I've seen a few things down deep in the sea. I wanted to talk about, you know, good old sea turtles. Woo! In Hawaiian language, we like to, Hawaiian culture, we like to say honu. They're very beautiful. If you have been able to be in front of one at some point, it's amazing. Big ones, small ones. Sometimes you swim with them.
Size of this coffee table.
Yeah.
It's ridiculous.
Crazy. Yeah. Most of them are about 3 to 4 feet long. Average weight is 300 to 350 pounds. You know, that's very typical. There are five different types of sea turtles that just live in the Hawaiian Islands. Five different types. Basically, the green turtle is number one. Most of us see just that one, and that's basically its name. They name them by their colors. If you didn't know, most turtles, lakes, ponds, land turtles, big tortoises, what they do when they're scared, you know, they like to hide. They go poop, and they hide in their shell. Sea turtles, they're not like that. They can't. They are not able to use their shell as a hiding home, you know. It's basically just for their inner body shelter to protect their organs from people, from sharks and things like that. Listen, I've seen some crazy shit down in the water. Some fights, some blood, some tears.
You guys got like a chicken fighting like ring down there?
Chicken
of the sea fighting?
Exactly. I see all kinds of crazy shit down there. Eels strangling some fucking...
You guys gamble? Yeah. Do you guys gamble
some
anything?
Fish, like...
Do mermaids gamble?
We definitely gamble. I mean, you know, we find things in the ocean. There's, you know, there's not a whole lot to work with other than all of your trash, which there's a lot of.
Oh, boy.
So, we find things. These are treasures to us. We're like, oh, my God, I could use this. I see some lady threw out her rollers. Oh, my gosh, I've been looking for a set of rollers. You know, nice. That's treasure. Sometimes you find a knife that has, like, some crazy witchcrafty stuff on it. And you're like, I really don't want this. But some crazy merman wants that shit. And they have, like, a beautiful necklace that maybe you want. So you're like, yeah, let's trade.
Yeah. So is it true that you guys use forks as combs down there, or is that just propaganda from Disney?
Like, it's you really true. Do that? I mean, that's like prime. If you can find something to brush your hair with, a fork is definitely a good one. Sometimes you find a comb and you're like, yes, let me hold on to this. Let me stick it in my shell bra. If you're like, why do mermaids even have shell bras? Like, they could just be naked. It's, you know, these are like our little pockets. We don't have, you know, we can't put on jeans like you ladies can do and have the pockets. So the shell bra is the pocket, basically. You can store necessities in there. Okay. Yeah. Oh, back to...
Sorry, what else you got?
That's okay. Back to turtles. If you see turtles and you're like, oh my gosh, is this sea turtle crying? If you're like looking closely, you shouldn't be too close. How close do you think you have to be? It's okay to be in Hawaii, Mr. Dennis. Do you know?
Wait, how close can I get to a crying turtle? Is that what you said?
To any honu turtle.
Let's go with 100 yards.
3 feet? Is that a
3 feet? Woo!
Is that right? Allie, what do you think on that? How many feet? It's 6 feet.
How far do you have to be away from a sea turtle when you see it in the ocean?
Absolutely 6 feet. 6 feet.
At least a human's length.
Exactly. We want to protect them.
There's humans that are only 3 feet.
Them.
Yeah.
Do not give credit to the turtles.
No,
they
corona
have
to the turtles.
So. Over half of sea turtles are actually they have a condition where they get tumors on their bodies, and that's what most of them end up dying from, is from these tumors that they get on their bodies.
It's not a tumor.
And they're actually saying that the tumors are getting worse because of the pollution in the water. That definitely is not helping the sea turtles' tumors, you guys. Just saying. If you're thinking that you see a sea turtle and you're like, oh, is this sea turtle crying? It might be, because they're like, oh, I don't know. My baby daddy left me. I don't know.
So much garbage in the ocean.
Maybe. Yeah, exactly. It These could be assholes. That, or it could be because sea turtles excrete the salt from the salt water. They drink it because they need to stay hydrated, but they can't have salt, so their body excretes it through their eyes out of their eye hole.
Salty.
That would kind of hurt. I hope that that doesn't hurt for them. Salty. You think, like, if we secreted salt, that would be like, ugh, that hurt really bad.
Yeah, that sucks.
But anyways, next fun fact, pretty much the last one is, so if you've seen Finding Nemo, there's that turtle is like the cool turtle, and you're like, is this turtle high? Yes, he is high because he eats a lot of jellyfish. Jellyfish are known to make sea turtles basically get high. The poison in jellyfish have a certain chemical that reacts with sea turtles.
Oh, so
very, very well.
Do mermaids get high then?
We do. You know, we do. Yeah, you know, we
Water time.
One of us is
we can actually
me.
Eat jellyfish as well and basically get the same kind of high that a sea turtle does. Except for us, it kind of burns. It's kind of like poison.
Don't fucking bullshit me.
It is. So, you know, there's other natural ways to do it that are not going to burn down your esophagus when you eat a jellyfish. And that is they are iridescent seaweed. Not just any seaweed. You can't just, like, smoke seaweed. People are like,
are you crazy?
Seaweed, no.
Seaweed?
Exactly. But these iridescent-y ones, I don't know if y'all can see. I have one. This is a pretty good one. This is a pretty good size. Mm-hmm. This will, if you smoke the
There's
seaweed
There's definitely
every
some
day,
crystals on that, y'all. Some crystals, definitely.
This is about a week. You can smoke some herb for about a week and get your good fix in. It's
You're fucking
tough.
Crazy.
If you're wondering what you smoke it out of, you know, we find trash everywhere. We find bottles of JMO. We find beer cans. You know what's up. We learn from you. I learn from watching y'all smoking your weed from the docks while sunbathing.
I'm pretty sure that there's probably some shipments that went down in the ocean. And
I know how to smoke
a bunch of
seaweed.
Like 5-pound packs that like floated to the bottom and you guys have been smoking. Woo, bubbles.
Woo!
Okay. So, Mermaidia.
Thank you for having me.
I appreciate you coming really through great. With some ocean facts.
Hey, woo!
Turtle.
Holla, holla, holla.
Pretty cool, but why don't you taco about me next week?
Ooh,
ooh,
I like it.
Ooh, taco poke is one of my favorites. Ooh, that's ooh, one of those ooh, things ooh, I think ooh. Only you can get here in Hawaii, maybe
Ooh,
Japan or some
if
shit.
If you haven't been to Lahaina Fish Company, which Ooh. I work, they have an amazing taco appetizer, Mediterranean style, super yummy.
Man.
But I will definitely talk about octopus next week.
Chopped
I love
up
it.
Octopus, that shit is delicious.
We're pretty cool.
Woo.
We can fit through any little crevice.
Change colors too, y'all. You're changing colors.
Human color.
Ow.
Maybe octopus can smoke the seaweed too.
I've seen that they can escape. These motherfuckers escape from the aquarium too. You know anything else that escapes from the aquarium besides an octopus? I don't think so. Good luck.
Ooh.
Free Willy. I heard Free Willy escaped some movie.
Good times.
Woo!
So, guess what we need? Viewer content. Y'all need to send that in. Whiskey Trap 188 Gmail is easy. Make a commercial. We use this super easy app called InShot. It's like a multi-track recorder where you can lay like videos and sound and music and then recorded live shit. It's awesome. You can make anything you want. It's all like as much as creative as you want to be. But I think it's time for another shot. Ready? You ready? You ready? Let's go. I think it's time for a shot. Excuse me. Jeez, Louise.
You're supposed to wave it for me. I
Well, I'm sorry. I'm talking and I'm waving.
Slow wave.
Okay. Kids at home. Shot time. You want to grab that new bottle? There's a new bottle around here somewhere. I'm pretty sure this old bottle's out.
Can I put this on the table?
Hey. I hope everybody's having a good time during this quarantine and getting some shit together, you know? Like, you can't be just sitting around fucking going nutty, you know what I'm saying? You got to be doing something. Your art, or if you're into making toothpick fucking statues, or I know Buddy Archer be making mini bars and out of lights and like popsicle sticks and shit. That's just awesome. He made me one. I'm going to show you the next week. It's the Shark Bar. It's fucking great. I had a shot glass. Oh, that's a big pour. Woo!
A little extra.
So I don't know how you guys take shots where you're from, but here at our house, we do a low tide, mid tide, or high tide. And sometimes you got to take that low tide because you just did three high tides and it's only been an hour.
Or a holy
tide. Yeah. Holy. Yeah. Oh, yeah. You're like, they give you the 4-ounce shot glass and they pour it all the way. Dicks.
I don't even have one.
So, my buddy Arnold, he just called and said that he's about to call up Sam, and they're about to have a fucking good old talk. But we're gonna take a shot first. Y'all ready? Once again, y'all, happy Mother's Day to all the moms out there. I got to give it up to your mom for putting out, because if your mom wasn't putting out, you wouldn't be here. We wouldn't be friends. So good job, Mom. Or your dad got mad game. Either one. Your dad got mad game or your mom was putting out. You're here. Thank God. Ooh. Who do you think is making a quarantine baby? Okay, if you're going to be pregnant in 9 months, say it or not it.
Not it.
Not it.
Not it.
Definitely not it.
I'm going to go with not it. You.
You.
You. 9 months from now, 8 months from now, pushing out babies. It's going to be hilarious.
What about celebrity?
Rona. You can have babies named Rona.
Oh, the celebrity that's most likely to have babies?
Yeah. Trump's
what?
Trump's wife.
He's like, don't
yeah, right.
Who's that? Ariana? Ariana Grande? She's nice. She's young and fertile.
How about Luna George? She might be pregnant as we speak. Oh. Who's Luna George? That girl. Oh,
all I know is, you know, Doja Cat's looking pretty fine, so if I was to get anybody pregnant, it'd probably be her right now.
Oh!
Riri's my girl for sure, but we're talking about the new school. Doja's looking good. You guys know. See it from the front. Wait till you see her from the back. Woo! Wait, y'all didn't take your shot yet? What's in your hand? Oh, sippy, sippy. Sippy, sippy. What up, Arnold? Y'all ready?
No. How are you?
What else should we do? What else do we want to show? You want to crack in that maybe a nice little like gardening video or
parkour.
I don't want the parkour one.
We're back.
Where? Yeah. What up? Everybody at home having a good time? So.
Parkour.
How about we ask some random questions? I like this random question stuff. So. When you're allowed to go sit down at a restaurant and you can be the first person to get a reservation anywhere in town, where's it going to be?
Sally Pepe.
Sally Pepe. Ow.
Amigo.
Amigo.
Sports bar.
Oh, sports bar. Taking reservations.
He doesn't love me. Which restaurant do I want to take a res?
A reservation too?
First reservation in any place that's about to reopen. Where are you going to, where are you picking?
Oh my goodness. Man, I don't know. You okay. Go, you
well
go.
Anyways,
you think about it.
I'm doing Lahaina Grill. Fuck that. I got
Lahaina
enough
Grill.
Fucking unemployment
Gerard's.
Cash.
Gerard's. I'll say Gerard's if you're going to say Lahaina Grill.
Yeah. I'm going Lahaina Grill. I'm getting the motherfucking taster menu. I'm tasting all that shit. I love it.
I've never been.
I'm getting from the land.
We live a block away from Gerard's and Lahaina Grill. Never been. We'll go.
In case y'all didn't know, the taster menu at Gerard's is like $110 a person.
Ooh.
The taster menu at Lahaina Grill, I think, is $89 or something like that a person. But it's like 8 courses. It's delicious. So?
It's good for a fancy after work drink. We've had some good girls after work sessions there.
Cocktails are amazing. I don't know if you've ever been there, but man, cocktails.
I've never been there.
Oh, she's going to happy hour for Monkey Pod.
Monkey Pod, yummy, yummy.
Late night happy hour is my favorite.
Late night happy hour, get those half off pizzas. That's what I'm talking about.
Still haven't done Sansa's late night thing.
Sports bar, Tic Tacs. Come on through, man.
Oh.
Do you prefer one with the orange carousel?
I make Tic Tacs the right way.
Yes.
I make it to the recipe. There's some people out there that do things, add shit. I'm not about that.
I like me zippies.
Like
ooh. Let's talk about right before the bars close down. We here in Lahaina do a bunch of fucking like mind eraser shots, right? It's ice. And then you put some Kahlua, some vodka, club soda. You drink it all at once. It's great. Mind eraser. You get fucking drunk. Gross. Then there's a Zippy, which is Chambord and vodka and club soda. And you slam it all at once too, right? But right before we all got shut down, the new one that I fell in love with was the peanut butter and jelly, which is the screwball peanut butter whiskey, Chambord, and the fucking club soda. And then you slam it all at once. Delicious. Peanut butter jelly. Peanut butter jelly with the baseball bat.
Peanut butter jelly time.
Okay, so what else, Fanny? Fanny Fonger?
I just want to go back in the water again. I can't with this busted
knee.
Oh, yeah. I haven't been able to go for over a month now, but it's almost better.
We only had one new case in all of Hawaii, which was on Oahu today. So that's amazing.
Let's hear it for Hawaii.
Woo! We're
making
doing
this shit
it right.
Happen, yo.
We're doing it right.
Getting those cases down.
It's been like a week since a new case
on
Maui.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, we're killing it. We're killing it right now.
Y'all better not
too
come
bad these assholes. These assholes are marketing Maui as the safest place on the planet to come to vacation. Don't bring your fucking virus over here. I'll punch you in the face. I'll punch you straight in the fucking corona face if I see your ass.
They're not going to have, like, a sign that says Corona.
I seen these tourist fucks yesterday with their Mustang getting fucking cool or getting going to wash the shit at the harbor.
Yeah, they're definitely tourists.
I was like, what the fuck? Team my ass.
I did just see that. So what they're going to do so that people are doing the 14-day quarantine, like, for real, and it's going to be up until, like, July. Each hotel room, they only give them one key for that first initial night. And, like, if they go out of the room, like, they have to go to the desk to get another key. And so they're going to track, like, how many hours it is until they get another key and yada, yada, yada. And, like, their security is, like, being legit about, you know, these guests making sure that they're staying where they're staying for 14 days. Yeah.
Bracelet. Ankle bracelet, those motherfuckers.
They ain't messing around.
Fuck that shit. So I just want to send out some love to our friends and family who are watching and commenting in the feed over here. We got Mr. Walter and
is Kirk being nice
Dan. Yes, I mean, he's keeping it offline, I guess. He sent me some texts.
Kirk.
Don't
Kirk
do
Carter.
It.
When this is over, we're going to have Kirk Carter over here, and he's going to talk conspiracy talk and stuff like that. I know right now we're calling this the webisode quarantine show, but I think we plan on doing this for a while afterwards. The quarantine goes down. We still want to hang out. And we can bring in a bunch of our other buddies who are super creative. And we can sit in the seat with us and talk about shit and play videos and actually get together and record videos together. And I think we're going to create some fucking awesome shit. This is just the beginning of some awesomeness.
Awesomeness.
We like playing
it's
together.
It's fun. This was a good idea. True. And, you know, we had the means to do it. Why not do something cool like this when we
seriously,
have
like, I like doing this, but I'm trying to do this for everybody else online, too. Like
exactly.
People who are bored as fuck, like, create a video. That's going to give you something to do for, like, one day of your life in the fucking week. And then I can play it. And then you got two things to do. You can make it and watch it later. Fuck. I mean, do something else besides just drinking vodka all the time. Fucking America. Fucking 5 out of 10 of the top selling alcohols, vodka. If you all watched earlier.
We have a handle of Tito's that we bought like literally the first day of quarantine, and we still have that bottle of Tito's. So.
Right, we're not alcoholics.
Exactly, we put it upstairs. We're not alcoholics, so a bunch
of
people don't
upstairs,
have to drink it.
So that everybody else don't drink it. I have a bottle of Sailor Jerry that's half empty. I've had for
let's not talk about it. Jameson's
2 months. Jameson goes a little bit faster. I'm not gonna lie, because it's my favorite.
It's still not that bad.
Should we take another shot? It sounds like a good idea.
What?
Let's take another shot.
Let's get a shot glass. I'll do it. But I ain't. Otherwise, I have to hop with my mermaid tail. I'm starting to like need some water. A mermaid can only go above seawater for like a couple hours.
You guys know
here.
About the Asian problem when they drink alcohol? They get all red.
Oh, I do too.
They get all red and on fire.
So flushed right now. Yeah.
Fanny Fong's feeling it. The same thing. The same thing is that with the Irish, man. We get drunk as fuck,
no,
and
yeah.
our cheeks
like everybody.
Are all red, and no, eyes start to close.
I need a shot glass. Mermaidia.
Slam this Corona. Okay. So, other random questions while we get Arnold. Fucking Arnold, man. He's calling on some bullshit-ass track phone, and the call keeps dropping. Buy a real phone, fucking Arnold. Fucking... Just go fuck at Walmart. You can get a fucking six S for like $100, bro. I mean, work it out.
Work it
okay,
out.
Okay, so
I know that song, you guys. High grade song.
From any streaming platform, what is your favorite show you're watching right now?
That I'm watching right now. I just finished that new Amazon show called Upload. It was kind of fun to watch. Kind of maybe a girlish thing. Kind of almost. Yeah, kind of a romantic comedy, but modern, futuristic, a little bit of science. But I hate it because it ends with one of those endings where it just, like, sets you up for next season. And then you're like, ah!
The cliffhanger.
I hate it. Yeah. But
I got to keep you coming back. Yeah. All right, Chris, what's your name? What's your deal?
I'd probably say Ozark. I know it's a little old, but the new season just came out like 3 weeks ago. It was fucking great. I've been watching The Flash. I've been watching that since day one, and now they're about to do season 5, 6 on Netflix. And then what else? The Outer Banks was pretty good too. Yeah.
What was that last one?
Outer Banks. Yeah.
What is that about?
It's about these kids that are looking for a treasure in North Carolina.
Ooh.
Yeah, they're like
Outer Banks.
It's like number 2, like on the Netflix top 10 now.
Maybe that was their inspiration. They're like, the Goonies did that shit. We can too.
Ooh, I thought of another one. There's a new show that I watched on Hulu. The first episode in particular is really
low
funny.
Tide.
It's
really
called
low tide.
Dave, and it's about some rapper named Lil Dicky.
Oh, Lil Dicky.
Lil Dicky.
Yes, yes. I thought it was funny. The first episode is my favorite.
What is this one?
FYI.
Okay. What about you, Amber?
I guess we started watching the Black AF, and that's
Black
funny.
AF. Black as fuck is hilarious.
I like it. It's hilarious, and it's just like simple, and I don't know. I really don't watch a lot of TV other than like SpongeBob and
we
Sesame
watched
Street.
That 80s. American Horror Story.
Yeah, the American Horror Story one is good. A lot of them I start watching, and I'm like, this is kind of way too cheesy and stupid, but this one's actually good. It's like horror, like, yeah, 80s horror-y. And
it's
stuff. Yeah.
No, that's what's awesome about it.
Yeah.
Some murder.
But this
one's
like
design.
A cool cheesy. They're all cheesy in its own He's weird way. Character. Ooh.
Ooh.
What's
Marilyn Manson's girlfriend? What's her name? The one that was she was going to death row and then but she didn't die.
Oh, I forget her name. Wait, was that her?
It's his ex-girlfriend. I mean, a long time ago.
Wait, what?
Emma, what's her name?
Emma Roberts?
Emma Roberts.
What? Marilyn Manson?
Yeah, Marilyn Manson dated her a long time ago.
No way. She's not even, she's like young.
Exactly. So what? It's Marilyn Manson.
I didn't know that. I'm a little.
If y'all
watch
the
80s
version of American Horror Story, there's the brunette chick who fucking.
It's freaking sure. Julia Roberts' niece.
Anyways, her. Okay.
No.
What I liked watching right now is Slobby Robbie. This dude fucking buys bullshit ass fucking shit at the store for fucking $10 and then sells it for $1,000 online. It's ridiculous. He has a store. It's like all 80s, 90s vintage shit I used to own. Pisses me off. And of course, Michael Jordan, The Last Dance. That's the dopest shit on TV. I don't care what any of y'all are watching. Fucking MJ making me cry every once in a while.
It is good.
Okay,
I'm
so
not even into it, really.
Let's take a shot.
It's really good.
And then my boy Arnold, finally, is he? No Arnold?
We'll do something different.
Okay. We're going to take a shot and we're going to watch a video.
Woo!
Sounds good. We've been yammering for too long now.
Blah, 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 blah. Good over here.
Only with
love, love, love.
Only with his love.
You go, clown.
Sprays of love everywhere. Might be rainbows up in here.
So your new name's Zen Clown instead of Zen Panda now?
Corona Clown. Love, love, love.
Ooh, yeah. It's looking good over here.
Only with his
love. Love, love,
Only with his love.
You go, clown.
Sprays of love everywhere. Might be rainbows up in here.
So your new name's Zen Clown instead of Zen Panda now?
Corona Clown. Love, love, love.
Ooh, yeah, it's looking good over here.
Let me get some mics. Let me get some mics. Fanny?
Hey.
This is the end of the show. Don't cry, okay? We're going to do it again next Sunday. It's going to be fun. You know what I mean? If you guys want, you send in some new footage for us next week. It's going to be awesome. We had a couple videos that we didn't play this week that we'll probably play next week. This last video, our buddy Rob, we lost him about a year ago. And it was just his birthday and stuff, so I figured why not play a video of him with his band playing the horn. This guy was loved by a lot of people. He was very, very artistic, and he did a lot of cool stuff, you know. And you know, we miss you, brother. And we'll see you in the galaxies afterwards.
I made one too, but it's not going to make the cut. So I guess I'll just post it to the site.
We'll put it on the page afterwards. But we love you, brother Rob.
I'm excited.
And
for
We'll get you going. And yeah. We'll see you next Sunday. Send in those videos.
Words with Fanny Fong.
I think on Wednesday we're going to do another little teaser video, talk a little yammy jammy, and I love you guys. We'll see you then.
We'll see you next time.
Woo!
Happy Mother's Day.
Central.